We know that six things need to happen to effectively teach and learn something and have engaged students. Trust the process. The six things must happen in more or less equal quantities, regardless of the subject or the learner. It's like a recipe. You follow it and the results speak for themselves. Trust the process. In this video, we're going to look at Coursera, edX, Udemy, and Khan Academy, four of the biggest names in online education. But are they trusting the process? Are they effectively using these six key components in their processes to ensure students learn well and can apply what they've learned? Central to the six components is, of course, the learner and the teacher. The feedback mechanisms and the learning environment that the teacher creates are what makes the process unfold effectively. Whether you're teaching online or in a physical classroom, it's how you set up that environment that determines the success of the learning experience. Stick with me to the end of this video and I'll show you how to create that kind of environment using Moodle or any learning management system for that matter. The purpose of this video is to highlight to us the things we should do to make our online teaching and learning interventions as effective as the best of the best. First up is acquisition. This is the most traditional form of learning, passing on information from teacher to student. It's something all four platforms do well, with their vast libraries of courses and lectures and beautifully laid out content. But is just throwing content at learners good enough? Platforms like Udemy and Coursera provide video lectures, slides, and reading materials. But are they interactive? Khan Academy stands out here, providing guided exercises after each video to make sure the learner isn't just passively consuming content. Next, inquiry. It's about empowering students to seek knowledge themselves beyond the material presented. This can be as simple as directing learners to additional readings or prompting them with thought-provoking questions. Coursera does a decent job here with rich lists of resources and research prompts. EdX also encourages learners to dig deeper through inquiry-based projects, while Khan Academy provides questions after every video, asking students to actively engage. Now, discussion. This is where learning gets social. Learners need opportunities to talk about what they're learning, whether it's in forums, live sessions, or group chats. The goal is to allow students to build understanding by explaining concepts to their peers and debating ideas. All four platforms offer some level of discussion, but Coursera, edX, and Khan shine out here with strong peer-to-peer channels and active discussion boards. Udemy's discussion spaces are less structured, one Q&A forum per course. The instructor has the option to feature a question that may be pertinent to all in the course. Their QA spaces are out of context to the lectures. Next is practice, especially retrieval practice, one of the most effective ways to learn. It's not just about watching a video, it's about doing, trying, failing, and learning with feedback. Khan Academy excels in this area. Its exercises after every lesson, especially the hard ones, reinforce learning through repetition. EdX and Coursera also do well with hands-on projects and coding exercises. However, Udemy often leaves it up to the instructor to create meaningful practice activities, which can vary in quality. Then there's collaboration. Learners must work together to achieve common goals, which helps them to reach a consensus on what are the important facts, how everything fits together, and by so doing, reinforces their understanding. But how well do these platforms foster teamwork? Coursera and edX offer group projects and peer review systems that encourage collaboration. Udemy doesn't quite reach the same level, lacking structured peer collaboration. Khan Academy is mostly individual-based, which can be a drawback for learners who thrive in group sessions. Finally, creation. This is where learners take everything that they've absorbed and create something new, a product that synthesizes their understanding. Coursera and edX do well here, with with capstone projects that challenge students to apply their learning. Udemy also allows for assignments that could serve as capstones for the learning of its students. But completing assignments is not a prerequisite for earning a certificate. But there's an interesting insight from my experience as a Udemy instructor. Students on Udemy tend to focus more on watching videos than actively participating in assignments or creating final projects. And that's a missed opportunity. By the way, I have a Udemy course on PowerPoint for educators, and I'd love for you to check it out. You'll find the link in the description below. If you complete the assignment at the end of lecture 18, you can submit it and I'll personally give you feedback on your creation. It's a great way to apply what you've learned and take your skills further. So, are these platforms trusting the process? To an extent, yes. Each one has strengths and weaknesses. Some of them more or less align perfectly with all six components. Platforms like Coursera and edX stand out. Khan Academy is brilliant for individual learning, and Udemy gives flexibility, but it is a hit or miss depending on the instructor. Now that we've seen how the major platforms handle the six components of effective learning, let's take a quick look at how you can do the same using Moodle. If you've never explored Moodle's full potential, this will give you a few ideas to make your courses as successful as these big names. For acquisition, you can use Moodle's text and media tools to share information, diagrams, videos, and much more. The key is to design clear, visually engaging content that is easy for students to consume. It's not just about quantity, but quality. For inquiry, don't just point students to helpful resources, teach them how to find good information on their own by introducing them to online safety, effective search techniques, and how to avoid fake information. This fosters critical thinking and independence. When it comes to discussion, Moodle's various forums are perfect for creating focused, meaningful conversations. But here's a tip: reward good participation. Moodle allows you to award badges and level up incentives for active engagements, which encourage students to get involved. For practice, Moodle's H5P interactivity tools are fantastic for creating engaging activities with immediate, detailed feedback. You can also dive into Moodle's lesson activity. Though it can be challenging to master, the rewards are worth it for deep learning experiences. Collaboration is where Moodle really shines. Use tools like the glossary or wiki activities where students can work together to create shared knowledge bases. You can also try the board or notes activity for collaborative brainstorming and peer feedback. And finally, for creation, the sky's the limit. Whether it's essays, videos, or projects, Moodle has plenty of tools to support creative output. And with the right setup, some of these tools can even help you grade assignments automatically. But my personal favorite? Ask students to create a PowerPoint presentation on a key topic. It's a versatile way to get them thinking and demonstrating what they've learned. By actively selecting the right activities for each of these components, you can create an online learning experience that rivals the best platforms out there. And the best part? It's all within your reach using Moodle. Thanks for joining me today. If you found this helpful, please leave a comment below about your favorite Moodle activity or tool. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more insights on online teaching and learning.